Hello, dissenters. My name is Italics, and I am here today with this beautiful fairy tale story in a mature setting made by Telltale Games, makers of The Walking Dead. And for some of you, that's going to be enough to convince you to go buy this right now, as well you should. I finished episode 1, which is the only episode currently available on PC, had a brilliant time, and I want to go play it again. You take on the role of Bigby Wolf, aka the Big Bad Wolf, trying to make a new life for himself. All of these fairy tales have made their way to live in Fable Town, where they can supposedly start anew, but some of them have a bad reputation. Like the Big Bad Wolf. He ate some people. That's not good. So he wants people to view him a little bit differently. That's your primary motivation in playing. Not to mention you're solving some murders and some creepy scenarios. In addition, tons of other fairy tales make their appearance. From the Headless Horseman to Beauty and the Beast to Snow White and the Woodsman. There are a ton here, and it is really, really fitting. Somehow they've made these fairy tales fit in this very mature environment. So if you're not comfortable with a lot of swearing, blood and gore and all that stuff, you should probably stay away from this, but like I said, if you like The Walking Dead, you know what to expect. Pretty much the same gameplay. Choose your own dialogue as you go along, and you get to play however you want. And you're going to be able to make some choices along the way. And I've avoided spoilers in this video, so there's not going to be anything related to the main storyline. All I'm doing is showing you one small choice that you make within the first episode. Here I'm talking to Beauty, and she's kind of looking a little bit suspicious. She's leaving the apartment where she's living, and you don't know why. She warns you, please don't tell Beast for me if you'd be so kind. And I chose to stay out of it. But I might have the opportunity to do one thing or the other later on. We'll see. But the primary gameplay is going to see you making decisions. You're going to have to choose how extreme you want to be in some situations, whether or not you might want to finish somebody off and kill them or spare them. That's the most extreme example, but others are smaller, more subtle like this, that might have larger repercussions later on down the line. And to that end, I did feel like my choices mattered a little bit more than in The Walking Dead. And that's only based on the preview that I saw for episode 2. So, right now, I'm really excited, and I'll tell you why. I love the voice acting, I love the dialogue, the gameplay is very simple. If you're expecting LA Noir here, you could probably go somewhere else because you're not going to get that kind of gameplay. The action is all quick time events, and even though normally those sound like terrible things, it's brilliant here. It really works. The art style is especially good, with the neon lights everywhere, the hard comic book outlines on everything. It looks really good. The characters, really personable, likable. The storyline is easy to get into. The mystery is thick, but the fairy tale nature of it in the mature setting really keeps things fresh in a way that I've never seen before. So much so that I think I'm going to go read the comic book series that this is based off of. That comic book series is called Fables, in case you were curious. When you're not talking to other characters or making decisions and choices or doing the action sequences, you're going to be doing a lot more investigation where you have a bit more free time to look around the beautifully detailed environments, examine objects, and touch them to see what they do. Like this elevator button. What could an elevator button do? I don't know. It's a mystery. But it's the point-and-click adventure game at its heart, and that's where most of the gameplay is going to derive from. Investigating, like right there, I just saw that I missed something that was on the ground. I don't think I even clicked on that. My bad. Now I gotta go back and play the whole game again. Now we're seeing the result of my earlier talk with Beauty, whether or not I'm going to say what she's been up to. So I have a choice of saying whether I saw her. I can tell him the truth, lie to him, or just stay out of it, which is initially what I told Beauty I was gonna do. So I told the truth, and I got a little quip for Beast as a result of that. There's a lot of sweet dialogue like that. Ultimately, I just had so much fun with this game. Telltale really did manage to make lightning strike twice in the same place. The Walking Dead was great. This is maybe even better than episode 1 of The Walking Dead. I think it's a really strong start, and I can't wait to see what the other 4 episodes add. I am really excited, if you couldn't tell. Thank you guys very much for watching this video. Hope you enjoyed it. And if you have any thoughts on the game, let me know in the comments below. I'd be interested to read what you have to say. I don't think you'll be disappointed by The Wolf Among Us. And if you are, well, I'll just be disappointed in you. I'm just kidding. Thanks for watching. My name is Italics, and I will see you next time.